You've worked hard, you've done your duty, saved your pennies, and now it's time to think about retirement. But before you let loose, you may have critical questions. How can I pick the best plan for me? Where do I go for the right information? What are the tools to make my money grow? Strategy, information, solutions, and advice from qualified credentialed professionals. Joe Anderson and Al Clopine of Pure Financial Advisors have the answers to your retirement plan. This is Your Money, Your Wealth.
Good morning, everyone. Show's called Your Money, Your Wealth. I'm your host, Joe Anderson. Did you like that intro with, like, the whole movement up there? This is our first TV program. Big Al and myself have hosted a radio program for the last 10 years. And what we're doing is we're bringing our radio program to TV. So there's a lot of things on my mind that I want to get through and I want to discuss with you today, because there's a lot of things when it comes to your overall retirement dreams and wishes, you need to figure out exactly what you need to do. So I'm going to be walking all over around this set here until we get this thing nails, because this is our first show and I want to get to what's on my mind. All right, let's get into this. When you look at retirement planning, there is $19 trillion sitting in retirement accounts. That's good because people are saving some money, but it's bad because most retirees now are going to be faced with a ton of taxes. When you look at these retirement accounts, every dollar that comes out of these plans is taxed at ordinary income. So there's a lot of strategies that you want to make sure that you take a look at in regards to mitigating that tax bite as much as you can. Most of the dollars that the baby boomers have saved are inside these retirement accounts, and every dollar they're going to get forced out. The whole rules of thumb is changed. When you look at in retirement, you'll be in a lower tax bracket. That's true for some people, but if you've done any type of savings, we found out that you might be in the same tax bracket or potentially higher, depending, of course, of how much money that you saved. So with that, I want to bring in my partner, Big Al, to discuss taxes in kind of the state of retirement that we're in right now.
Hi, how you doing? Joe, I completely agree that in the current environment, the tax rate's gonna be a big deal for a lot of people, and here's why. It's because when you hit 70 and a half, you're required to pull money out of your IRAs, your 401ks, and what's gonna happen for a lot of you that have done the right thing in terms of saving is you're going to be in a higher and higher tax bracket. And this is a bit of a surprise for most people, because what happens, let's say you retire at 65, for example, and maybe you don't even take Social Security, but you're just living off your non-qualified assets, your non-retirement assets. So now 70 and a half comes along, and all of a sudden, you have to take money out of your IRAs, out of your 401ks, and where you were paying very little tax, the tax rate escalates. And that's why we want to talk about taxes and retirement on this show, because it really is something that you can control.
You know, Al, I found out a long time ago, I'm a certified financial planner, you are a CPA, is that taxes play such a key role in someone's success or failure in retirement.
No doubt.
Because they don't realize of how much tax that they're going to pay. And if you look, you got $17 trillion in debt right now. Where do you think tax rates are going to go?
Yeah, they got to go up.
They have to. We've been lucky to have the Bush tax cuts, or extra, over the last couple of years. And so when you look at prior to the Bush tax cuts back in 2000, we had surpluses. So they brought rates down to historic lows just about. And then now this funny effect is happening. You have a ton of money in these retirement accounts by the baby boomers that have done a good job saving money. Right now they're approaching retirement, where all of those dollars have to come out to provide their lifestyle. If they have a pension or Social Security, maybe they don't need to live out those dollars. And then, like you said, at 70 and a half, now they're required to take those distributions out. And what we see is that it just keeps on kicking them up into higher tax brackets.
Yeah, no question. And again, this is something that is going to impact a lot of people negatively, because they're not realizing how much they're paying in taxes, Joe. And it's we talk to people in their 70s, 71, 72, 73, and over and over again, they tell us, man, I wish I would have met you guys sooner, because then I could have done some things to change my situation. Now, not that to say that if you're in your 70s and paying a lot of taxes, there still are strategies that work for you. But here's the point is if you're newly retired in your 60s, 50s, whatever it may be, or if you're still working in those age groups, there's some things that you'll want to consider tax-wise to put yourself in a better position long-term.
Right, we want to talk about a concept called tax diversification. It's taking a look at, all right, well, where's your money held and how's it taxed? There's tax-free dollars, there's tax-deferred, and then there's taxable. So during this program, we're going to get into all different areas of where to invest and how to mitigate that tax bite as much as you can once you start taking the withdrawals, once you start taking the distributions of your overall retirement. You know, most people's retirement is like a car wreck. I mean, they haven't done any type of savings whatsoever. Let's go to this clip of one of my favorite movies.
Watch it, bonehead.
So when you look at, you know, Grumpy Old Man, that was filmed in Minnesota.
Yeah, your hometown.
So yes, every show, I want to play a clip from Grumpy Old Man. I want to show them ice.
Then I'm not watching. I'm done with this show. Yeah,
this is probably going to be our last show, Al. I want to show people them ice fishing. Have you ever been ice fishing before?
Of course not. I'm a San Diego native.
This is an experience that I think every retiree needs to get into. You sit, you drill a hole, right, in 20 below weather.
Okay.
And then you sit on a bucket. And then you fish.
I'd rather watch a movie and not actually do it.
So what we want to get into is some key tax moves to look at your overall situation. So, Al, why don't you get into what are some of those key tax moves that we're going to get into the show?
Yeah, there's really probably three things that you want to consider. And number one really is got to be the tax loss harvesting. Thank you, Ty. This is our first show. We're hearing things in our ears. So. At any rate, tax loss harvesting, what this is all about is if you have assets outside of retirement, you actually, they'll go up, they'll go down. When they go down, you actually want to consider selling them because when you sell them at a loss, you create a loss that nets against future capital gains. That's stock, mutual fund, real estate, index fund, whatever it may be. So that's number one. We'll get into that. Number two is Roth IRAs. And Joe, Roth IRAs and Roth conversions, you need to be considering getting money into Roth IRAs. Why? Because tax-free income in retirement is going to be your friend. When you hit 70 and a half and you're in these higher tax brackets, you're going to want to have some of your income tax-free to stay out of those highest brackets. And finally, asset location really is about where do I put the assets within my various accounts? Because you may have retirement accounts taxed at ordinary income, you may have Roth IRAs tax-free, and you may have taxable accounts that could be capital gains. And you don't want to have your stocks and bonds all in the same accounts. You want to put them in different spots to maximize your tax savings.
So I'm going to have you break it down when we get back from the break. And then where I want to do is talk about implementing some of these strategies. Taking a look at how does all this make sense and why is it relevant to me? What are some of the things that I can do right now to mitigate taxes, not only today, but also in retirement? Because it's key, because I think a lot of times advisors in the industry itself focuses on the investment piece. Here, this is the asset allocation. Here's the mutual funds. Here's the stocks to purchase. Look at Wall Street. You know, the markets are at all-time highs. You look at interest rates, right? It's very difficult to generate any type of income. We're living a lot longer. You have health care on the rise. You got Social Security that's insecure. So there's a lot of different dynamics that we're going to get into on this show each and every week to make sure that you have the right information in your hands to make really good decisions with the money that you saved. So when we get back, we're going to bust everything down for you. I want to get on a whiteboard and make it crystal clear on some of the things that you need to take a look at. So don't go anywhere.
Life is good, wild and sweet. Let the music play on.
Hey, welcome back to the program, folks. Show's called Your Money and It's Your Wealth, TV style. I got to tell you, Al, TV is just a little bit different than radio. I'm sweating bullets here.
You look fine now. You must have some makeup.
Yeah, you know, at the break, people rushing out. I think I lost about...
They had to get towels on.
I think I lost 8 pounds.
They couldn't do a washcloth. They had to get a big, giant towel.
They're like, oh, my, are you going to be all right? Are you dying? Are you dying on us? No, we're back. We're good. I'm feeling it. Feeling a little bit more in my element now after, first time.
Yeah.
So give us a break.
Oh, look at us. You know,
hey, looking what good. Hey, so let's get into the substance. I want to talk tax planning. I want to get into our tax moves that people want to take a look at right now, because our opinion that tax rates can only go one way. If you're concerned about paying more taxes, not only now, but also in your overall retirement, stay tuned for this. Because when you look at where you invest, it's not necessarily what you earn, it's what you keep. It's the after-tax return that you have to be concerned with, because if I get a really good return but I lose most of it to taxes, it's not worth all the risk. If I can reduce my tax bill, I can reduce the amount of risk that I take out of my overall investments. And so that is the key to any strategy when you're taking distributions.
Yeah, absolutely, Joe. And that's why we really want to focus on some three keys that you ought to be considering, whether you're working or in retirement, although we're specifically, easy for me to say, talking about retirement. And number one is called tax loss harvesting. And this simply means that if you have assets outside of retirement, what you want to do is monitor as they go up, as they go down. You will be monitoring that normally. But here's what happens. When it goes up, you're excited. When it goes down, you're upset. And you tend not to look at your statements because it's upsetting. I'm going to tell you to do this instead. As your assets go down, I want you to sell them. Not because you want to lose money. Of course not. We're not saying that. But I want you to sell that asset because that creates a loss. That's called tax loss harvesting. And that loss offsets any other capital gains on your tax return dollar for dollar. A capital gains is a sale of a stock, bond, mutual fund, real estate, whatever it may be. Utilize that loss against future gains. Now, if you have more losses than gains for that year, even better, because now you have a loss carry forward that carries into next year. When you have a loss carry forward, you can then sell gains next year and pay no taxes. This is key when you're in retirement because you want to create some tax-free income.
Yeah, and I guess if you look at it this way, Al, is that when investments go down, people unfortunately do sell, but they go into cash.
That's a good point.
Right? So it's not looking at selling, going to cash, and getting out of the overall markets. You still want to have the same integrity of the overall portfolio, because as those investments continue to go up, you'll have those losses to offset. You know, I'm going to let you go to the next topic, but I want to get to the whiteboard and start drawing some things out for people to kind of take a look at. This could really blow up on us. So,
yes, I know.
You're my partner.
It's live TV. But in the case of number two is a Roth conversion. And here's another way to create tax-free income. And that is taking some of your assets out of your retirement account and getting it into a Roth IRA. What's a Roth? A Roth is a retirement account that grows 100% tax-free, which is a lot better than tax-deferred. Tax-free means you'll never pay tax on that account, whether it's you, your spouse, if you pass away, if you both pass away, your kids, tax-free forever. What's tax-free? The principal, the income, and the growth. How do you get money into that Roth IRA? Well, you can do a contribution if you're working and you're below certain income levels, $5,500 if you're under 50, $6,500 if you're over 50. But there are limitations there. The second way is to get money into the Roth by a Roth conversion. Taking some of your IRA dollars and converting it to a Roth. Yes, you do have to pay taxes on that conversion. But once you do, all future dollars grow in that Roth 100% tax-free. And tax-free is pretty good, Joe.
Well, here, let me draw this out, if you guys can put the camera on me. Because there's really three different pools of money that people can invest in. And they're all taxed differently. And I know this is going to look awkward, but here we have tax-free money, we have taxable money, and you have tax-deferred dollars. So when you're looking at investing, and what you want to look at here is how it's taxed. Your investment is taxed. So if I look at a Roth or tax-free, that would be a Roth IRA. Okay? That could also be municipal bonds. Taxable investments or non-qualified accounts, that could be your mutual funds, that could be stocks, that could be bonds. Your tax-deferred assets, of course, these are your IRAs. That could be your 401ks and 403bs, SEPs, simples, all the above when it comes to your overall retirement assets. Now, when you pull dollars from this account to create a retirement income, you don't pay any tax at all. 0% tax. That's the best rate. It doesn't get any better than that. These assets here are subject to a capital gains rate, which is right now 15% for some of you. It could be zero or it could be 20. Also, you have to add the healthcare bill, another 3.8% tax on top of that, depending on what your taxable income is. But here's the kicker. These dollars here in these tax-deferred accounts are all subject to the highest tax rates. That's ordinary income. And here's the advice a lot of you have received over the years, is continue to defer these accounts. Defer, 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 defer. Don't touch that money until you absolutely have to. Yes, I understand that you don't necessarily want to pay tax, but where are tax rates going? The longer you potentially keep that money in there, the more tax that you're going to pay. So Al was talking about a Roth IRA conversion. This is something that you might want to take a look at. That is taking assets that's in this pool and moving them up into a tax-free environment. So let's say I have some investments here, $20,000. I convert $20,000 into a Roth IRA. That $20,000 grows to $40,000. You'll never pay another dime in tax ever again on those dollars. Where are tax rates potentially going? We feel that they're going up, so you want to control the taxes long term. Because if I have money in each of these different areas, when it comes time to for me to draw down the assets to create the income that I need, right, I can control the taxation. If everything comes out of this tax-deferred account, this is one of the biggest problems that we see. Everything is taxed at the highest of rates. So if I have a little bit of money in each of the different areas, you're going to control your taxes, and you'll pay less tax. Then you can take on a lot less risk in the overall investments. Al?
Yeah, Joe, the other thing that we want to talk about in this show is really thinking about where you should place your assets, your stocks, your bonds, your mutual funds, real estate, and the like. And you kind of want to invest these pools a little bit differently because, as you just mentioned, they are taxed differently. So you kind of want to put your assets that have the highest growth expected, which would be stocks, mutual funds, and index funds that invest in stocks. You'd rather put those in the taxable account or the Roth account. Why? Because the Roth account's taxed at zero. The taxable accounts, as we mentioned, if you hold that asset for at least a year, it's taxed at a 15% capital gains rate for most of you. And your safer money, your bonds, you generally want to put that into the tax deferred account. Why? Because that generates ordinary income anyway, and everything that's in that tax deferred account comes out as ordinary income. So if you'll just do that, because a lot of people, Joe, get this exactly backwards.
Right, and if you look at the overall strategy, is that, all right, well, let's continue to have my high aggressive or maybe stocks in this account. But what happens there is that all that growth is then going to be taxed at ordinary income rates when you pull the dollars out. If I have the money here, stocks, as Al just described, okay, so as stocks go down, I can sell stock A and buy stock B, right? So I capitalize on the loss. I don't want to go into cash. And then also when I have high flyers, if you will, I'm always going to be paying a less tax. Capital gains rates are less than ordinary income. So where you're positioning your assets is key to make sure that you have an overall strategy. The best component is making sure that you have dollars up into a Roth IRA or something that will grow tax-free. There's so many misconceptions about Roth IRA planning. Is that, all right, well, if I'm under 59 and a half, I can't do a Roth IRA conversion. That's false. You can do a Roth IRA conversion at any time, any age. The rule changed in 2010 that allows everyone that's watching this program right now to do a Roth IRA conversion. Prior to 2010, you had to have a modified adjusted gross income of under $100,000. That is no longer. So if you make $1 million a year or zero, you can do a Roth IRA conversion. If you're 30 years old or 90 years old, it doesn't matter. You can do a Roth IRA conversion. So you want to make sure that you're looking at some components of your overall retirement income strategy so that you can reduce that tax bill long term. I mean, that's probably one of the biggest mistakes we see, Al.
Well, it is, Joe. And again, it's taxation. That's something you can control. You can't necessarily control the market other than your risk profile. In other words, you can figure out how much you need to invest in stocks versus bonds. That's very important. But once you've done that, now you got to control your taxes, and you do have a measure of control on that. You can't determine whether stock's going to go up or down. It's almost impossible to predict. But if you put the right assets in the right accounts, then you will end up paying less tax. And that's the name of the game, because tax rates stair step up. So what does that mean? The more money you make, the higher the tax percentage that you pay. So if you can create some of your income tax-free, you can be living up in this world but paying this level of tax.
Hey, with that being said, we're going to dive into a little bit more of this. We got to take a short break. But I want to get into, when we get right back from the break, I want to show the history of the tax code. I want to show you where tax rates have been and where they are right now. So stick around. Don't go anywhere. You're watching Your Money, Your Wealth. Hey, welcome back to the program. Show's called Your Money, Your Wealth, right here on TV. My name is Joe Anderson. I'm a certified financial planner, also president of Peer Financial Advisors. If you want more information about our firm, you can always go to peerfinancial.com. What we're going to get into this segment, we have emails that we want to get to. We want to make sure that we're answering all the questions that you shoot out to us. So you can go to info@purefinancial.com. Info at purefinancial. If you have any question whatsoever, we'll make sure that we answer it right here on the air. A couple of other things that I want to discuss. We talked about tax planning, Roth IRAs, Roth conversions. There's a lot of stuff going on here, and so I get it. We want to make sure each week we'll slow it down to get you the nuggets that you need to make really good decisions. Also, if you want more help, I teach a retirement planning course. It's 6 hours. It's 3 hours one night. It concludes every day of the week, just about Tuesday through Thursday. So if you ever want to get more information or sit through this retirement planning course, I encourage you to go to our website at purefinancial.com. Check out a clip of, I think, me probably doing something stupid at a class. No one does that because our emotions drive us to make the wrong decisions. Risk factors are so important. So let's say, John, this is really important stuff. If you take a look, you got 10,000 baby boomers turning 65 every single day for the next, 12 to 15 years. There's a lot of information that people need to make sure that you secure a long-term retirement. We talked about taxes. Let me get back to taxes for a second, and then we're going to answer your email questions. Here's the tax rates. If you look at top marginal rates, right, we were in the 90 percentile for many years. It was 70% for 30 years. Now we're here. Where do you think tax rates are going to go? So that's why we're very excited to bring the show to you to get the proper tax advice that you need long-term for your retirement. Let's do this. I know that there's a couple of different email questions. So Al, let's go to the email bag.
All right, thank you, Joe. And we do really appreciate your email questions. And as Joe said, info@purefinancial.com. That's where you want to email us, info@purefinancial.com. Question number one, Joe, is what should I look for if I want to hire an advisor? And this is from Shelley in Mission Valley.
Well, there's a lot of different things that you want to consider when hiring a financial advisor. A, you want to make sure that they have credentials. There's a CFP, Certified Financial Planner. Big Al is a CPA. There's also a CFA, Chartered Financial Analyst. That at least helps the consumer say, all right, well, has this person done some schooling? How well do they know their overall the topics? Another thing is we want to look at compensation structures. So there's fee-only financial planning, there's fee-based financial planning, there's commission-based, the list goes on and on. If you're working with a commission-based advisor, just know that there could be a conflict of interest. They're selling you product, they're generating a commission from that. A fee-only financial planner, they work on a fiduciary standard, which is extremely important because they have to put your interest before their own. A commission broker does not have to do that. They have a fiduciary standard towards their corporation, not necessarily the client. So that's probably the two biggest things. You want to make sure that you're working with someone that's credentialed and also their compensation structure. So fee only and a CFP, in my opinion, is the best way to go. Al, what else you got?
I completely agree with that. Let me get to question number two, which is, can I still convert to a Roth IRA even when I'm not working? And Joe, I'll take this one because we get this question a lot. And the answer is yes, anybody can convert. And this is a little bit of misnomer. To do a contribution, you have to be working, right? And you're limited to $5,500 per year contribution or $6,500 if you're over 50. You have to have earned income, you or your spouse, and your income has to be below certain levels. But a conversion is taking money out of your regular IRA and converting it to a Roth. Anybody can do that. It doesn't matter how old you are. It doesn't matter how much money you make at any income level. It doesn't matter how much you convert. All these things are wide open. So the truth now, and this is since 2010, because they took that income limitation away, so now anybody can do a Roth conversion.
And everyone probably should look at doing a Roth IRA conversion, because one of the best parts of a Roth IRA conversion, I'm taking money from my retirement account, I'm placing it into a Roth IRA. Now, I don't have to pay the tax on those dollars until April 15th the following year. So with that being said, there could be substantial growth in the overall account, depending on your investment strategy. The best part about a Roth IRA conversion, putting money from an IRA into a Roth IRA, you can always undo it. If you don't want to keep it in the Roth, if you don't want to pay the tax, just undo it. It's called recharacterization. So you could do the conversion today. You could wait until the performance of the overall account. You can look at your tax bill. You can clean all this stuff up later. So everyone should at least take a look at what is appropriate for you. Now, what we got one more?
Yeah, we do. We'll see if we can get to this quickly. So question number three is, I have a long-term capital loss carryforward on my return of about $150,000. Can I use this against short-term capital gains? In other words, I've got a long-term capital loss. Can I use it against a short-term capital gain? And the answer is yes. And a lot of people get this mixed up because they think short-term is for short-term, long-term is for long-term. And the truth is you can utilize either kind of loss carryforward against capital gain. What I'm talking about is when you sell a stock or bond outside of a retirement account and you sell it at a loss, that generates a loss that can be used against dollar for dollar against other capital gains. If you have extra capital losses, they carry forward for the rest of your life. You never lose them. And you can use those losses against future gains. And so therefore, yes, you can use short-term against long-term, long-term against short-term.
So we talked a lot today about taxes. We looked at Roth IRA conversions, Roth IRA contributions. We looked at tax loss harvesting. We looked at asset location. We looked at, all right, well, what's going on in the world of retirement? A ton of stuff that we crammed into a half an hour. If you want more information, you can always go to purefinancial.com, purefinancial.com. Join us next week. We have a lot more to go with this whole tax time bomb that you're building up in your overall retirement account. So we'll dive into the nitty-gritty of some of the things that you should be taking a look at. For Big Al Clopine, I'm Joe Anderson. Thanks so much for tuning in. We'll see you next week. See the rhythm rolling.